Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We're in the midst of Advent, so we are providing special Advent music today. Our opening hymn is in Missalette, number 261, Christ Be Beside You.
Let us ask his intercessions for us and for our church.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
With humility, together we say, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who gave the saint, O God, who gave the priest, Saint John, the cross, an outstanding dedication to perfect self-denial and love on the cross, grant that by imitating him closely at all times, we may come to complete eternally your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, proclaiming the mystery of God, I did not come with sublimity of words or of wisdom, for I resolved to know nothing while I was with you, except Jesus Christ and him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and much trembling, and my message and my proclamation were not with persuasive words of wisdom, but with the demonstration of spirit and power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. Yet we do speak a wisdom to those who are mature, but not a wisdom of this age, nor of the rulers of this age who are passing away. Rather, we speak God's wisdom, mysterious, hidden, which God predetermined before the ages for our glory, and which none of the rulers of this age knew for, if they had known it. They would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what eye has not seen, and ear has not heard, and what has not entered the human heart, what God has prepared for those who love, this God has revealed to us through the Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Responsorial Psalm. The mouth of the just murmurs wisdom. Trust in the Lord and do good, that you may dwell in the land and be fed in security. Take delight in the Lord, and he will grant your heart's request.
The mouth of the just murmurs wisdom.
Commit to the Lord your way, trust in him, and he will act. He will make justice dawn for you like the light. Bright as the noonday shall be your vindication.
The mouth of the just murmurs
the mouth of the just tells of wisdom, and his tongue utters what is right. The law of his God is in his heart, and his steps do not falter.
The mouth of the just murmurs wisdom.
Great crowd disciples were traveling with Jesus, and he turned and addressed them, "If anyone comes to me without hating his father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Which of you wishing to construct a tower does not first sit down and calculate the cost to see if there is enough for its completion? Otherwise, after laying the foundation and finding himself unable to finish the work, the onlooker should laugh at him and say, 'This one began to build, but did not have the resources to finish.' Or what king marching into battle would not first sit down and decide whether with 10,000 troops he can successfully oppose another king advancing upon him with 20,000 troops? But if not, while he is still far away, he will send a delegation to ask for peace terms. In the same way, every one of you who does not renounce all his possessions cannot be my disciple." The Gospel of the Lord. As I've said earlier, today we celebrate the feast of St. John of the Cross, one of my favorite saints, and let's try to get to know St. John of the Cross. "Where there is no love, put love and you will find love." This statement was written by John of the Cross, a man who loved and forgave those who had locked him in a dark 6-by-10-foot cell for 9 months. John's wealthy Spanish father had been disowned by his family because he married a poor weaver. Living in poverty proved to be too much for him, and he died before John was a year old. John spent much of his youth in an institution where he was clothed, fed, and educated. At the age of 17, he found a job as a male nurse in a hospital and was accepted into a Jesuit college. In 1563, he entered the Carmelite order. Then he enrolled in another university, where he did so well that he was asked to teach a class and to help settle disputes. When John met St. Teresa of Avila and learned from her about the reform of the Carmelite order, he decided to help with him. For this reason, he wore sandals instead of shoes and lived very simple in prayer and solitude. In 1577, the attitude toward reform shifted. John was caught up in a misunderstanding and imprisoned at Toledo, Spain. During those months of darkness, John could have become bitter, vengeful, or filled with despair. Instead, he kept himself open to God's action, for no prison could separate him from God's all-embracing love. During this time, he had many beautiful experiences and encounters with God in prayer. Later, he described his experiences in poetry. He wrote that, "In evening of life, we will be judged on love." In 1578, John escaped to southern Spain to join the southern Carmelites. There he held leadership positions and wrote reflections on his experiences, which show his deep spirit of prayer. In September 1591, he became ill and had to move to another place. He chose to go to Ubeda, where no one knew him. It was there that he died. John's three famous works are Spiritual Canticle, Ascent of Mount Carmel, and The Dark Night of the Soul. He is known as a mystical doctor. Together we say, St. John of the Cross.
Pray.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us all stand and present our needs and prayers before God. For the church throughout the world, may God bestow unity among all her peoples. Let us pray to the Lord. For public authorities, may God grant them the humility to be guided by His word. Let us pray to the Lord. For the unemployed and those who seek more fruitful work, may God's love continue to offer them hope. Let us pray to the Lord. For all gathered here in this Advent season, may God prepare a place in our hearts to receive the King of Kings. Let us pray to the Lord. And for all who have died in faith, may Jesus, the Lamb of God, welcome them into the eternal kingdom of the Father. Let us pray to the Lord. And today's Mass is offered for Richard Schaff, Julita Martinez, Amelia Navarez Alcantara, Rene Glenn Ancheta, and Isaiah Jeremy Lim. We pray to the Lord. And let us pause in silence for our personal prayers or needs. We pray to the Lord. God, in your great love, please hear and answer our prayers, and we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Look upon the sacrificial gifts we offer, Almighty God, in commemoration of St. John of the Cross, and grant that we who celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion may imitate what we now get through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength every year, and offer sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. Their great example lends us courage. Your fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we do give you thanks as an exaltation. Together we say, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all your faithful people. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, Padre Pio, St. John of the Cross, and all the saints who have visited you throughout the ages, we may marry to be co-heirs to eternity, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Together with our saint today, we glorify God, our Father, and we say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I give you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
Let us offer to others Christ's peace, and I believe we can smile to one another. Come on, we can smile to one another. Thank you for the smile. Peace. Peace be with you.
Mercy on my life.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. God, who in St. John and wonderfully made known the mystery of the cross, graciously grant that by drawing strength from the sacrifice, we may cling faithfully to Christ and labor in the church for the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
The Lord be with you.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth and ask his hand.
Thanks be to God.
If we have some like that every day, this church will be packed. Thank you so much for a wonderful music. Let's give them a big hand. Our final song,
our closing hymn, number 175 in the missal. Lo, our robes, their blue.